हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आर्कास्ट्रो साइंस एंड टुडे आई एम बैक अगेन विद येट अनदर न्यू वीडियो। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस दैट हाउ टू स्टडी द ट्रांजिट इन वैदिक एस्ट्रोलॉजी, हाउ टू सी दैट व्हेन ए प्लैनेट इज ट्रांजिटिंग फ्रॉम वन साइन टू अनदर, हाउ टू स्टडी इट, हाउ टू सी इट, हाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड द रिजल्ट्स, द पॉसिबल रिजल्ट्स विच इज गोइंग टू हैपन फॉर ए पर्टिकुलर पर्सन अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर हॉरोस्कोप, अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर एसेंडेंट। Many a times I see this type of questions or comments which I receive or even in the emails, that how to check the transit, should I check it from the ascendant or the moon sign or the sun sign, or what is the best way of checking it, how to understand the results. See, there are many ways, but the basic thing we have to understand is that there are 12 ascendants, there are 12 zodiac signs. Depending upon your zodiac sign, whenever a planet is transiting or entering into any house, that sign, that house can be any of your 12th houses. Like suppose recently Mars has entered the sign of Leo. So Leo can be any of your house depending upon your ascendant or your zodiac sign. Now consider your ascendant is Aries ascendant. Now there are millions of people who have Aries ascendant. So they all will have, or they all will experience different types of results. The main result will be same, but there will be different flavors added to it. The intensity, the magnitude of the deliverance of the result will be different for the different types of people. So when what we think and what actually happens, what we feel and what actually we experience in the real life, when they matches, we feel that life is all okay. But this does not happen every time. What we think and what actually happens, they both are different. Most of the times they are different, and that's the beauty. We have to be ready for something which is unexpected, something which is unpredictable. Now when we check it from the ascendant, means suppose what is your first house, the sign which is ruled by your first house, that is your ascendant. Like suppose your first house is Taurus, then you are Taurus ascendant. Suppose your first house is Gemini, then that means you are Gemini ascendant. If you see the transit through the ascendant, then you will feel that what is actually happening or what you are experiencing really in physical world, in this material world, what actually happens, how you do it, that actually matters, how you achieve it. You may think, or I may think, that this will happen, that will happen, I will do this, I will do that. Until and unless it happens, it gets fructified, we are not happy, correct? So that's the reason, the first thing I will say, that when you are checking the results of a transit, the first thing, check it from your ascendant first, because that is the thing which is going to happen. Depending upon your ascendant, because for the Aries ascendant, Mars, which has transited few days back in the sign of Leo, it will be 5th house. For the Taurus, it will be 4th house. I am talking about the ascendant sign. It is going to happen, it is going to physically manifested in your life. And why the ascendant? Because ascendant says about your personality, about your health, about how you look in front of the world, or how the other people see you. Why the other people? Because just opposite to the ascendant is the 7th house. 7th house is the other people, the masses, and how they are looking at you. That is the ascendant, because what you do, because whatever things we do, people will have some reactions to it. There will be some consequences to that work. So that's the reason we have to check the transit definitely from the ascendant. Secondly, if you go through the ancient scriptures, any astrological classical book, I'm talking about Vedic astrology, you will see that they talk about transit from the moon sign. If you go through the astrological classic Faldipika, you will see that there the transit has been described from the moon sign, means how the transit is going to take place or what type of results you are expecting. It has been given through the moon sign. Now, when a transit is taking place, what type of psychological state of our mind is, that will determine that whether the transit is going to be good or it will bring difficult times. Means how we feel, what we think. Moon will actually take us to the world of imaginations. We can imagine the things. It is our emotions, means what we feel. That is your moon sign. So if you are checking the transit through your moon sign, it means that due to this transit, what will be the state of your mind, your psychological ups and downs, change of the state of emotions. You will be happy, you will be cheerful, or you will be in the state of confusion, doubts. You may be angry, you may be sad. That will be determined by the moon sign. But here one big question comes. What we think, does it happens every time? We may expect that, or we may think that next month I will be doing this. But most of the time the things does not work in our way, and then we complain. Oh, I thought this happened. I thought that this I will do, but this happened. That was the person who was the reason behind my failure. Suddenly I don't know from where he came. So there are different types of excuses. Okay, I will not take the word excuses. Sometimes it happens that we can't change the destiny, we can't change the things which are going in our way. That means even if you see the transit from the state of your mind, that is the moon sign, many a times the things what happens in your life due to that transit, you have no control over it. So when we don't have the control over it, we feel as if we are restricted, isn't it? And that brings the change of state of our mind. Either it will make us much more challenging, or we may be put backward, we may be sad. There are different types of changes, the psychological changes, just like the phases of moon. And that's the reason it is important to check the transit from the ascendant first. Yes, definitely, if you want to understand the transit, that due to this transit, what is the change is going to happen to my mind, to my psychological state, to my emotions, whether I will be happy, whether I will be sad, what? Definitely for that you must check the transit from the moon sign. But if you want to see that what is going actually going to happen really in the life, then for that you must check the transit from the ascendant. Another thing, the most important part, is that many a times what we think, what we feel, or what we have thought of, it happens. It happens really. And we become very happy, we become very cheerful that, see, I thought of that and I did it. It happened. So it brings happiness, isn't it? But many a times, people can be scared of this. This can turn out to be scary. I thought of that and it happened. I was fearing and it happened. My God. So, this is all the game of our mind. If you can't control the emotions, if you can't control the mind, then what will happen? It will overpower you. Then whatever you do, you will feel that you are doing. Your mind is making you do. And that turns out to be the ego. That I have done it, I have done it. I, me, myself, everything. So that turns out to be the ego. And that's when the game changes. That's when the planet, which is transiting, they have got that power to influence us. That is the reason we call it Graha. Who can eclipse our mind, eclipse our life according to their ways. So when we are away from our ignorance, away from our arrogance and ego, that's the time when we are detached from any results. Okay, that's the philosophical part. So the first thing is that you have to check it from the ascendant. If you want to understand that what is going really going to happen in the while the transit is taking place. Secondly, if you want to understand that what type of changes it is going to bring psychologically or the emotionally on the emotional state of our mind, how we are going to feel it, then check it from the moon sign. There are other lagnas also, other ascendants also. Like if you want to check it, you can check it from your dasa lord also. Like suppose someone is going through the dasa of Saturn. Okay. Now suppose Saturn is sitting in the sign of Sagittarius. Suppose Saturn is sitting in the sign of Sagittarius in your chart. And you are going through the Mahadasa of Saturn. So make Saturn as your ascendant. And from that, check the transit. This is another way. So see, these are the different layers, different chapters. First you check from the ascendant, then you check from the moon sign, then you check from the Dasa Lord. Another way is that checking from the natal planets. Like suppose if you are checking the transit of Mars, or suppose you are checking the transit of Mercury, Venus or Sun, whatsoever. Recently Venus has also entered the sign of Leo, isn't it? Now suppose Venus is sitting in the sign of Taurus for your horoscope, and Venus has entered the sign of Leo few days back. So from Taurus, Leo will be 4th house, isn't it? So make Venus as your ascendant and check it. If you want to check the transit of Venus, so make the natal Venus as your ascendant. That is another way. So there are many ways, multiple ways by which we can check the transits. Normally we don't check the transit from the sun sign, but here one thing has to be checked, one thing has to be understood is that in the Faladipika, when we study the Faladipika, Mantraswar, who has written the astrological brilliance, that is Faladipika, he has mentioned that out of all the ascendants, out of all the lagnas, the moon sign lagna, the moon lagna means where the sign wherever your moon is sitting, that house or that sign, that lagna is the best, is the supreme, because it will think of your psychological state of your mind, your emotions. But at the same time, he also mentions, he also says that out of all the lagnas, that means he has never said that we cannot check the transit from other lagnas. That means if we have time, if we have the zeal to understand the depth of the astrological knowledge, to understand the actual secret of this transit, the result, then we must check the transit from all the lagnas, be it your ascendant, be it your moon sign lagna, be it the natal planets, be it the sign where your dasa lord is sitting, or even if it is necessary, check it from your sun sign. But it is very complex, I am saying you. Checking the transit alone from the ascendant and the moon sign, it will bring different results, isn't it? So when you are checking from different kinds of ascendants, lagnas, it will add up the complexities. Now, after checking all these things, still people will say, because I get the mails and I get the messages, people say that it happened like this, but something else also happened. I didn't expect that, but something else also happened. Why is it so? Why is it happening during this time only? Why not before? Why not after that? So, what are the other parameters? Let us come to that. The next parameter is your dasa. What type of dasa are you running? You see, whatever Mahadasa, Antardasa and Pratyantar dasa you are running, that planet, whatsoever house it rules, whatsoever planet it is sitting with or conjunct with or associated with or expected by, that planet becomes very strong during that time period, because the time period of that planet is running for you, for your horoscope. So whenever transit of that planet will take place, it will give you more powerful result. See, powerful result does not mean that it will be good or it will be bad. The dignity and the intensity of the results, the quality of the results will depend upon how it is placed in your horoscope. If it is strongly placed in your horoscope, then the transit results will be influenced in a positive way, depending upon what type of sign it is transiting or what type of house it is transiting. Obviously, it will be again be adding some flavors to it. Another thing is that suppose that planet which is under consideration, that planet in your horoscope is sitting with some other planet or getting aspected by some other planet. So due to that also, the results will get modified. So dasa, antardasa and pratyantar dasa will have a major say in the transit, how it is taking place in your life. So even if you check the transit through your ascendant sign, moon sign or the all other lagnas which I said, because Sage Mantrasura has already mentioned that out of all the lagnas, means you can check it from any lagna depending upon your time and space, your availability. Okay, you must also check the dasa sequence. Next is the Ashtakbarga points. When we go through all these things, we forget about the Ashtakbarga points. Ashtakbarga points will say you that what type of results, the quality, the actual hidden quality. Even if it is, suppose, a planet which is functional benefic for your chart, which is owning a very good houses, transiting to a very good house, you are expecting a very better result, a best result, but still you felt that during those months or during those years I didn't had the results which I expected to have. Even if you will say that that planet I expected that transit to that house, to that sign will bring good results, it owns such and such good houses, still it didn't give me the best result. Why? Check the Ashtabhyanga points. Suppose a planet is entering a sign. Check what is the Ashtabhyanga points of that sign. If it is more than 28, that transit will be good. Check if that planet is contributing any point or not in that house, or how many points it is contributing. If it is contributing 4 or more points to that house, the results will be good. If it is contributing less points, though, that transit will bring some kind of challenging situation in your life. Or suppose the total Ashtabhyanga points of that sign is less than 28, then again it will bring some kind of challenges in your life due to that transit, and we cannot ignore it. The most important thing is that people say that I didn't get the result such and such. People forget that some results were there, and that is the reason he or she is complaining. Some results will be there. We don't need to ignore it. We must accept the truth that yes, something happened. It can be good. It can be something which is not expected. Okay. So suppose some difficult time is coming. It is, why it is coming? It is making us strong. Wind will not be in our favor every time. The flow can be against us, isn't it? And that's the time when our strength will be checked. I know it is easier said than done, but that's the truth, isn't it? So Ashtabhyanga system will also play a role depending upon your planetary transit. So when you are checking the planetary transit, when you are thinking that I must know the correct answer, then you must spend some time to check that also. Okay. So these are the common parameters by which we can check a particular transit. We can understand that how the transit is going to be, how the transit is going to behave or give the results in our life when a planet is ingressing into a sign. Be it the fast moving planets, be it the slow moving planets, whatever it is. And suppose if you want to understand that how the transit is going to take place in your horoscope in a such a detailed manner, if you want to understand that how, what type of results you are going to get, then you can definitely check the links in the description section for the consultation. Click the subscribe button, click onto the notification bell icon so that every time I make a new video, you get notified instantly. And share this video to your near and dear ones. Your comments are always welcome to me. So that's it from my side. I hope you have liked this video, and this video I hope that it will clarify most of your confusions that how to see a transit in a proper way. But again I will say that if you are feeling that yes, I must check the transit in an easier way, then yes, check it from the ascendant first, and yes, you can check it from the moon sign also to understand that what type of emotional ups and downs or what type of psychological state of mind this transit is going to bring in your life. So by this note I will end this video, and till then, next time when I come back, I will bring some another video for all of you. Keep showering your love and affection. Thanking you. Bye bye.